my God. Thank you. Yes, yes. Welcome. Welcome to Saturday night service, Fire and Water. Amen. God bless you. Thank you so much for joining us tonight from wherever you are tonight. Thank you. We just want to welcome you. Welcome you to our service tonight, to our Fire and Water family. Thank you so much. And to those watching for the first time, from wherever you're watching, let us know where you're watching from. Thank you so much. I know we have a daughter right now in Florida at a naval base. She's watching in a room with her friends. God bless you. God bless you, Sydney. And right now, before we get started, we just want to pray for all our frontline workers, for our military who's out there working the front lines. Let's all come together and let's pray together for them and for the service tonight. Father God, we thank you. We praise you and we glorify you. We give you honor and we give you glory once again, my Father. Tonight we pray, my God, that you move in a mighty way in this service, that you touch lives, those that are watching, my God, those that are joining in tonight with us, my God. We pray that your anointing will touch, will just bless them, my God. Have a night of breakthrough tonight, my Father, a night of deliverance, a night of breakthrough tonight, my God. We pray for our frontline workers, our medical workers, the doctors, the nurses, those that are working 24/7 trying to protect us, our military, my God. We pray that you protect them, you watch over them, their families, my God. We give you honor and glory for each and every one of them, my Father. Bless your holy name. Tonight we pray, my God, for a move of God tonight, that you touch everyone, my God, in Jesus' name, that you break chains, that you undo the yoke of the enemy, that people be set free. Oh, my God, in Jesus' name, chains be broken, all delivered from the hand of the enemy. We bless you and we thank you. Be glorified tonight. Let's continue worshiping. Thank you. God bless you. Amen. Hallelujah.
You are in the arms of the Father. There is love like no other. He who formed all things offers love to me. Where you go, we will follow. Through the dark, through the narrow, and in all
nothing.
in this world that compares to all you are. I want to be close to you. I want to be close to you. There's nothing in this world that compares to all you are. There's nothing in this world that compares to all you are. There's nothing in this world that compares.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Right now, watching on wherever you're at, just lift up your hands and just praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. We're not looking for victory. Remember, we have the victory through Christ Jesus. Amen. Who strengthens us. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Amen. And what He's begun, He's going to bring to completion. What He's begun, He will bring to completion. Amen. God is in control. He's on the throne. He's still on the throne. Amen. And He's going to have the final say in every circumstance, in every situation. The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Amen. Praise the Lord. So happy that you've joined us tonight once again. God bless every one of you. We are praying for you. We love you. And just believing that we are going to be starting up church here sooner than later, God willing, next month sometime. I'm just speaking it forth. Amen. I'm speaking it forth that next month we're going to open up these doors. Amen. Praise the Lord. And we're going to be lifting up the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Believe that with all my heart in Jesus' name. And if you're at home right now, say a good amen right there where you're at. I was going to say if you're at home. Well, most of you are at home. Amen. Praise the Lord. And praise the Lord. I just want to also just encourage everybody throughout the service tonight. This can be awesome. We're going to have a testimony that's going to bless you. We have a song that's going to bless you. It's going to be a special night tonight of encouragement, not to give up, not to give up, not to give up. Amen. There's victory in not giving up. Amen. And I just want to encourage you to share the service. What an opportunity to be able to witness right now, to evangelize, where some of us maybe, you know, it's like, well, how, you know, I want to share my faith, but it just, you know, it's sometimes it's just not, it doesn't come easy for me when I'm out and about. This is, I mean, what a great opportunity to be able to witness right now, where right now walls are down and people's hearts are open to receive. And all you got to do is just click on the share button and the program, the service goes to somebody. And what a great opportunity. Yes, Ira, if you can, you know, and you can share it, you know, again, you know, on Facebook, fawic.org. And you know, you can just go to the webpage, I should say, and then press on the watch live at fawic.org or facebook.com, fawic2. So let's get the word out, amen, and then get the word out that people can go back and see the service again on YouTube to watch the service. And faith comes by hearing the word of God, an opportunity to go back and just hear the word of God to strengthen your faith, to increase your faith. Praise the Lord. Amen. Again, so glad you joined us. With us tonight also is Willie Joan, our friend, and has joined us tonight. Faithful servant. He works at Teen Challenge Arizona, making a difference, changing destinies for the glory of God. Truly, when we say here, it's not the way you start, it's the way you finish. God is using you to encourage and build up young men, you know, men that society has given up on. Even some churches have given up on. Oh, amen. Yes, but we know there's miracles. Those are miracles. Amen. Amen. And all they need is somebody to believe in them. And I want to say thank you for what you do. That's Frontline Ministry. Frontline Ministry, and the director here in Phoenix, Jim, phenomenal. The whole staff there, phenomenal. Yeah, Willie, will you just greet everybody and just let them know about Teen Challenge?
Amen. Praise the Lord. Just glad to be here tonight. So honored to be here with my dear friend, Pastor Gus, one of my best friends in the whole world. Just got to tell him that right now.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. We've known each other about 10 years. We go back an entire decade. Amen. It's really a blessing. honored to be here. But Teen Challenge is truly a blessing, and we've been around for nearly 60 years. We've been told we have an 86% success rate.
Come on now.
Praise the Lord, and God is good. And the reason why is because we believe in Jesus. Amen. We believe in the power of prayer. So when the government asks us, how come we have such a high success rate, we just say prayer. We say Jesus, and we just keep saying Jesus. And for some reason, they don't want to hear that, but that's okay. You know, the numbers don't lie. Amen. And the results don't lie either.
Come on.
And we live in a life of miracles. Every day I'm seeing miracles happen from guys that come from the most broken places, from the most broken homes, some of the most traumatic situations you could ever imagine. And to see when they surrender their hearts to Jesus,
yes,
and give their lives to God, He not only takes the addiction or the desire for the drugs or the alcohol away from them, but He gives them a purpose and a destiny.
Come on.
And they feel called to do something great for God. They feel called to do something so amazing for God, to get tied and get plugged into their purpose. And that's even more exciting when they get off the drugs, and then they can find their purpose in Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
So we're just so excited. It's a 13-month program. Amen? And if you have any questions about the program, want to know more, you can go to our website at www.tcaz.org. Stands for Teen Challenge Arizona.org. God
bless. Say that again.
www.tcaz.org. That stands for Teen Challenge Arizona.org. God bless you.
And I know the success rate, that's real, because we've had many that have been part connected to our church.
Amen.
And even, you know, many that have moved on and are doing big time, relevant ministry that are touching lives. And who comes to mind is Robert Marquez right now.
Robert Marquez.
A director in New Mexico now. Amen.
Amen. Director.
And touching so many lives, the women's and the men's, and his wife, Amen, Tracy, together. They're just doing a phenomenal job.
Amen.
And then John Humbach was just here.
Humbach.
He was sharing his testimony, and he's connected to our church and part of the outreach,
Amen,
ministry.
Praise
and the
Lord.
Bus ministry. And
it's a blessing.
Just, man. Praise God. That's why we can't give up on anybody,
can't
huh?
Up. Can't give up. It's not can't how you start, it's how you finish.
That's,
Amen,
right. Praise the Lord. You know what I want to do is, you got, you know, right now, let's just for a moment. Do you got something right now? Just what's on your heart right now? Just a song. Just do something. Whatever's on your heart right now.
No what? Weapon formed.
Come on.
Against me. Shall prosper. It won't work, no weapon.
Oh, come on now.
Formed against me shall prosper. It won't work. God will do what He said He would do. He will stand by His word. He will come through. God will do what He said He'll do. He will stand by His word. He will come through. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. No.
Come on. Decree it right now. Write it home. Right now. Where are you at?
It won't work.
That's right.
No weapon formed against me shall prosper. No, it won't work. No, it won't work. No, it won't work.
Come on.
No, it won't work.
Someone needs to hear that.
No, it won't work.
Someone needs to hear that.
No, it won't work. No, it won't work. No, it won't work. It won't work. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. No, it won't work.
Hallelujah. Amen. Awesome. Right now, at home, right, just lift up your hand and say, I receive that. I believe it in Jesus' name. That's a word right there. Amen. Praise the Lord. If He's for us, who can be against us? Praise God. Amen. If He's for us, who can be against us? In Jesus' name. Praise God. What I want to do right now is, Tager, come here. I'm just being led by the Spirit. You mentioned earlier, and I want to pray right now. Pastor Tony, I'm going to have you come up here in a second. This coming up Monday night, We're really excited about this. Of course, we're going to be here tomorrow morning live again at 10:30 a.m. So get the word out. 10:30 a.m. for Sunday morning service. But then on Monday night, because there's so many prayer requests and so many needs, we decided as we gather here for our prayer time, we are going to pray live online with you. We're going to connect with everybody 7 o'clock on Monday night. Facebook or on the web, you can, you know, jump on the web page again and click on the click on the live button, watch live, or go on Facebook. We're going to be here Monday night and want to encourage you to connect with us, to send in your prayer requests, and we're going to pray live corporately around the world together for every one of those prayer requests on Monday night. And I believe there's going to be great breakthrough, that God's going to move in a powerful way, because the Bible says when two or more come together in agreement, it's done. Asking you shall receive, seeking you shall find, knock and it shall be open. Amen. Two is better than one. When we come together in agreement, there's power to that. There's victory to it. And I believe there's going to be great breakthrough, great victory, healing, restoration for His glory. Amen. So that's Monday night. But KJ, I want to pray even tonight. Actually, I got a phone call earlier from our dear friend in Pennsylvania, and his son needs prayer, dealing with something right now that they're trying to figure out about surgery. And anyway, so I want to lift him up in prayer also, and also your dad.
So my father, like many of you know, right now is a really bad time to get sick, and I know Pastor Tom and Cheryl, I know you've been through something right now, but my dad's been fighting cancer. He also has diabetes. It's a double threat, and he's been infected, and he's a very proud man. I don't know, a lot of guys out there know about proud fathers and just not want to go to the hospital. So he the infection got worse. They didn't know, and I don't, you know. The infection's so bad that the skin just came off when they took the socks and the shoes off, and it's spreading to his heart. So my family can't be there right now in the hospital with him. So please, I know that we're all going through hard times. You know, my situation's no worse than what anyone else is facing right now. So, you know, maybe as you're praying for your family and what's going on, what you're going through, maybe you could throw in a prayer for my father too. He's a good man, and he's the reason why I didn't lose faith in God, even after prison, even after drugs, even after everything else. He was an example of what a godly man should be, and I aspire to be that in my life.
Gager, you know, and what was awesome is tonight you're like, I know I need to be here. You said to me, and remember, and we've talked before, and you've heard me say, as long as there's a comma and there's not a period in the sentence, there's still a comma in his sentence. So we're gonna agree and we're gonna believe, because he is a miracle working God, and with God all things are possible. And I know God sees your heart, and here you are tonight, worshiping Him. And you're telling him tonight that I trust in you. You're the one that's brought me this far. You're going to bring me the rest of the way. And if it wasn't for my father, and as you just shared earlier, you know, I wouldn't even be here. So God sees your heart right now as you stand in the gap. Amen. And then I also, Anasto, that's my friend Mike's son, needs a healing also. I mean, we really need a move of God in his life, so I want to lift him up in prayer. And I know many others right now need a miracle, a breakthrough. And I just believe right now the anointing of God, the power of God's here. And we know the anointing of God removes burden and destroys yokes. Amen. And he is the same yesterday, today, and forever. So if he healed 2,000 years ago, he heals today. If he delivered 2,000 years ago, he delivers right now. We believe that, amen. We serve a resurrected king, amen, a resurrected savior that's still making the impossible possible. And that we're going to believe that here for your father, for my friend's son, and also for whatever other need there might be out there. I want you to connect with us right now. And you know, Pastor Robert, I just feel this in my spirit. I want you to pray for for Cager, for his dad. Amen. And then, Pastor Tony, I'm going to have you come up. Why don't you come up right now? So I just feel led right now. And we're going to come in agreement. And then I want you to pray corporately for everybody, for healing. Amen. Praise God. Go ahead.
Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord God, we just worship you, God. We praise you, God. We thank you, God, that you are on the throne, Lord. And you know about our situation, Father. And I just lift up Cager's father, Lord, to you right now, Lord. In the name of Jesus, we lift him up to you. And you said wherever two or more gather in your name, whatever we ask for, it shall be done, Lord. And we ask you, God, we ask you, Holy Spirit, that you would go there and touch Cager's father, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. We just lift him up to you right now, that you would touch his body, God, that you would heal any disease. Lord, you sent your word to heal our disease, Lord. God, and we believe in you. We trust in you, God, and we lift him up to you right now, God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, by the power of your blood, Lord God, for you were wounded for our transgressions. You were bruised for our iniquities, Lord. The chastisement you bore was for our peace, and by the stripes on your back, Lord, Cager's father is healed, Lord. And we lift him up to you in the name of Jesus, Lord God. And we thank you. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for a miracle. We thank you for a good report, Lord God. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The Bible says that Abraham staggered not when he received the word from God that he was going to be the father of many nations. It was impossible for Abraham to have any children. His time had passed. But that's the God that we serve. He is the God of impossibilities. What's impossible to us, it's possible to God. Amen. So tonight, we're going to do the possible. And we're going to believe tonight. And we're going to lift up our faith tonight to the God of impossibilities. The God that can do it like he did it then. He will do it now and he'll do it tomorrow. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And right now, we're going to come in agreement. We are going to pray right now. Right there where you're at. Right there where you're at. Just lift up your hands, lift up your voice, and begin to pray. Begin to lift up the name of Jesus. Begin to give him glory for the testimony, for the breakthrough, for the deliverance, for the healing against cancer, diabetes, blood pressure, in Jesus' mighty name. Right now, my God, we pray. We seek your face, my Lord. We ask you, my Father, for you to do the impossible in our lives, my God. We look to you, my Lord. We look unto you, my Father, because only you can do it, my Father God. We lift up our faith. We lift up our hands unto you, my Lord. Father, right now we pray. We come together and we agree, my Lord, for all those, my God, who are asking for a miracle. Prodigal sons, wayward daughters, restoration of the home. They're coming home in the name of Jesus. They're coming home in the name of Jesus. Father, breakthrough. Breakthrough, Lord, against the spirit of suicide right now. I feel it in my spirit right now. Oh, right now in Jesus' name. You've come to give us life and life more abundant, my Father God. In the name of Jesus, oh, we worship you. And we stand on the promises. We stand on the word of God. And we lift up our faith unto you, my God, our God. You are the God that supplies all our need. You are El Shaddai. You are, oh my God, hallelujah. Father God, tonight we thank you. We thank you for the miracles. We thank you for the testimonies. My God, we wait on you. Thank you, my Father, because we know you can do it. And we trust you. We trust you with all our heart. And we lift up our prayer requests. We lift up our hands. And we thank you. And we ask it all. Father, heal this nation. Heal this nation, my God. Heal this nation, my Father. We ask it all in the mighty name of Jesus. Right there where you're at. Give them thanks for your victory. Your breakthrough. Give them thanks right there where you're at for the breakthrough, for the deliverance. Give them breakthrough that the chains have been broken. That family curse has been broken in the name of Jesus. Oh, we thank you, Father. We praise you. Bless his holy name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Just worship. Just worship. Go ahead. Go ahead. Just right now. Oh, the blood. Just for a second.
Oh, the blood
of
Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus. There's healing in the blood. Oh, the blood of Jesus. There's healing in the blood. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood. Oh, the blood of Jesus.
Coming through the camera right now, right into your homes. Yes, there is. Healing. Healing.
There's power in this place.
Power going right through right now into your homes.
There's power in this place.
Yeah, 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 yeah. For his glory. Deliverance right now. Right where you're at.
Deliverance in this place.
Right where you're at.
Oh, we are set free by the power of Jesus.
Yes.
We are set free by the power of Jesus.
Right now, right where you're at. Receive. Believe. Hallelujah!
There is freedom.
Presence is tangible and transferable. Come on. Receive.
In this place.
Tangible and transferable. His presence.
In this place.
His power. His word.
There's
right where you're at. Receive. He's your healer. He's your deliverer. He's your restorer. He's your answer. Hallelujah. And with him all are possible.
There's healing in this place.
Lord, just like a wildfire that's out of control in the physical, right now in the spiritual, let your healing power, your strength, your power, breakthrough, healing, spread right now like a wildfire in the spirit to everybody right now in Arizona, in Phoenix, throughout the United States, and throughout the world right now. Let it spread. Spread. Heal. Restore. Save. Deliver. In your mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. For we know in this place, you are the answer. You are the solution. You are our healer. You are our deliverer. And you're still healing. You're still delivering. You're still setting the captives free. And we believe it tonight. And right now we lift up our hands and we say, Lord, we believe it. We receive it. Just say that right now at home for yourself and for the people you're praying for right now. Say, I believe it. I receive it. And start to praise the Lord. Start to thank Him for what He's doing right now in our midst. God is moving right now. God is moving right now. Believe it. Receive it. And give Him all the glory. Give Him all the honor. Hallelujah. And Lord, we give You all the glory. We give You all the honor. We give You all the glory, all the honor. We need You, Lord. Your people need You. Oh, God. Breakthrough. Breakthrough. Encourage Your people tonight. Strengthen Your people tonight. Woo. Hallelujah. Thank You, Lord. Thank You for what You're doing right now. Are falling and breaking off your life right now. Confusion is falling, leaving now, and clarity is coming to you right now in the name of Jesus. Clarity to hear the voice of God. Clarity, clarity right now. There's clarity coming throughout the world right now. As you're hearing my voice, clarity. To hear His voice, His news, the good news, the truth, and the confusion is falling, it's going right now in the name of Jesus. And the only voice, there's clarity coming that you'll hear, that you'll move, that you'll take the next step, will be the voice of God, because now there's clarity to know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. The Bible says you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Clarity right now. Oh God, clarity. There's clarity. There's clarity. Clarity. And peace that surpasses human understanding. I pray peace. I pray peace right now to everybody, your families, your homes, everyone and everybody connected to you. Peace. Peace that surpasses human understanding. To rest in Him and to trust Him. In Jesus' name. Oh, amen. 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 Wow. 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 Presence of God is so strong here right now. And remember, I said this earlier, the anointing, the presence of God is tangible and it's transferable. Yes, it is. And I know right now, I know with all my heart, I know it with all my heart that God is moving right now. God is touching lives right now, healing and delivering right now. Some of you right now, you know that you know God has touched you right now. Thank Him. Give Him all the glory. Give Him all the honor. And let me say this too. Moving forward, you have a responsibility to share it with somebody else. Your miracle, your turnaround. It's happening right now because somebody else needs to hear your story. Somebody else needs to hear what God has done for you tonight to bring hope to them, to be a miracle in their lives. They need a miracle. Oh, hallelujah. There's a fire spreading in the spirit. Ah, I feel a fire stirring and spreading in the spirit all across Arizona, all across the United States. A fire, a wildfire of His Spirit moving around the world. India, Uganda, Greece, Indonesia. And it's cleaning and taking out obstacles that are in the way of the people of God, the work of the Lord. God is strengthening His people for this hour to stand, to be seen, to speak, to be heard. And when we speak His word, it'll demand attention. And for God, as we speak His word through us, He'll confirm it with signs and wonders that will be undeniable to bring many into the kingdom of heaven, to pull many out of the pit of hell and into the kingdom of heaven. In Jesus' mighty name, there's a fire spreading. I said there's a fire spreading. There's a fire spreading. Woo!
Fire. Holy Ghost fire.
Come on, say that. Shout fire.
Fire. Holy Ghost fire. Fire. Holy Ghost fire. Fire. Holy Ghost fire. Fire. Holy Ghost fire.
My God. Holy Ghost, fire. And when the enemy tries to come in to contain it, just like in the natural, you know when they try to control fire sometimes, they try to set up a perimeter or a line to control the fire. But then when the wind picks up sometimes, even though you try to do everything in the physical to prevent it, to contain it, no matter what you do, because there's so much wind, it jumps the line and it keeps on spreading. What I'm trying to say is no weapon formed against us is going to prosper. God is raising up His church that the gates of hell shall not prevail against thee. My God, church, soldiers, man of God, women of God, arise. It's time to rise up and be the church in the name of Jesus. Not trying to hide behind the shield of faith, are picking up the shield of faith, crossing over enemy lines with the fire of God, with a shout of charge and a spirit of taking over in the name of Jesus. Carry the solution as vessels of God Almighty. The presence of the living God lives in us. And we are a solution to somebody else's problem. My God. Church, it's time for us to be that solution into somebody else's situation. It's not a time to put our heads down. It's a time to lift up our hands and understand we're in the midst of witnessing the greatest harvest of souls to come into the kingdom of heaven. What an hour to be alive. Rise up, man of God. Rise up, woman of God. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. Wow. Wow, I just want to say, wow, if you're at home, I just want to just lift up your hands and just say, wow, praise the Lord. That's the God we serve. Wow, I believe there's a lot of wow that's going on tonight. Wow, wow, and to Him be all the glory. Wow, woo. Our trust, our faith is in God, not man, not the government, but in God, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the one that created the heavens and the earth. That's where our faith is in. Amen? Man, even to their best of their ability, will come up short. They can mean well and they still come up short. But God will never fail you. He's undefeated. I said He's undefeated. Run to Jesus. Trust Jesus. Praise the Lord. What a God, what a Savior. Well, praise the Lord, everybody. And you know what? It is Saturday night. You know it is Saturday night. This is, you know, this it's Saturday night. At Fire and Water International Church, Church in the Hood. This is Saturday night. This is how we roll on Saturday nights. Amen. Amen. Well, I just want to, tonight we're just going to, wow. Thank you, Lord. Tonight, what we're going to do is, I believe, man, God's moving so powerfully. I want to encourage you right now. Let us know if God's, as we've been praying, share your praise reports, share your testimonies, share your miracles tonight. Amen. Please share them online. Let us know. That'll encourage somebody else that's watching also. Please, we want to hear your praise reports so we can celebrate together and share them with others to encourage others. Well, tonight, what I want to do tonight is, why don't we do this? We have a great testimony. We're going to finish tonight's service. It's awesome. Just we're talking about Teen Challenge and how it's not the way you start, it's the way you finish. And we're going to hear a great testimony that just follows along with that. Actually, Tony and his whole family, his kids, that's going to be awesome. You guys are in for a special blessing. So please don't go anywhere. We're just going to be around. But we got another 15, 20 minutes. And I promise you, the best is yet to come, because that doesn't sound right. But how can I say that there's more, though? But then again, if you... It just, yeah, let me say it like this. There's more. There's another wave coming. Amen. Get ready for the next wave. Amen. Get your surfboard in the spirit and get ready to catch the next wave. Did I say that right? Amen. I just want to say, as we move forward tonight, thank you with all my heart for your faithfulness and your giving through this season. Because of you and your obedience, this church, as the pastor here, the staff, all of us have been so encouraged that truly God is in control. Because of your faithfulness, we just continue. The needs are being met. And I just want to say thank you for your willingness to adjust in your giving during this time and be and still and staying faithful with your giving, with your tithes and your offerings. So once again, as we pray for the offering tonight, three ways to give here during this season, through the webpage. You can go to the website at fawic.org and just click on the donate button. I can't even speak right now. Amen. I'm all messed up. Or you can send it in by mail at our P.O. Box, 16848, Phoenix, Arizona, 85011. Or you can come by the church, as many have done it, even tonight before the service, and drop off your tithes and your offerings. And once again, thank you, thank you, thank you for your faithfulness and your obedience. And all we ask for, you know, just to pray and just to obey the Lord. Amen. There's a blessing within it. And as we continue to reach the hurting, the poor, the afflicted, the addicted, and the lost. And Lord, I pray right now, even now that you speak to your people throughout the world right now, that you'll speak to them. And Lord, as they give during this time, that you're going to give us a greater harvest of souls to bring healing and deliverance and souls into your kingdom. So bless your people as they give right now, as you speak to them in Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen. Praise the Lord. Do we have one more? You guys have one more song before we, let's do one more song. We're going to do one more song. We're going to hear it. We're going to do one more song. Let's praise the Lord and thank him for what he's doing already. And then Tony and his family are going to come up, and they're going to minister to us a testimony, and that's how we're going to finish the service. So don't go anywhere. Let's praise the Lord. Come on. Let's worship the Lord.
Bounty won't light up. Bounty won't climb up.
What?
Coming out to me.
What?
Snow won't kick down. Fire won't tear down. Coming out to me.
Tony, praise the Lord. I love you, my brother. Amen. And I'm rejoicing with you. I know you shared this with me earlier in the week about you wanting to share your testimony. And I want to say how proud I am of you, because this is what the church is all about. And many in your situation, after pressing in, being clean and sober for many years, and then falling back down, and then getting back up, and then falling back down, and then getting back up, and then publicly coming up here testifying, and then still having another setback. But see, you give me hope, because you're what this church truly is all about, in the heart of Jesus, of not giving up. But it reveals your heart, because truly you have a cry for God. And I know there's many that are watching at home right now that truly have a heart for God, a cry for God. But a lot of people assume they know the whole story. But that's where I got some scripture on that. Man looks at the outward appearance, but God sees the heart. And as long as your heart cries out for God and you don't give up, there's great breakthrough in that. There's great breakthrough in that. And many need to hear your story, your testimony, because people have been stuck in that cycle. And the worst part is when you had victory and you lose the victory, then you're like, what's the point? I've tried and it didn't work out. You try again. Because with God, all things are possible. And you can do it. So you're an inspiration. I applaud you. To God be the glory. And then you wrote a song this last stretch that I know your children are going to come and sing with you. That's how we're going to finish the service tonight. But Tony, why don't you share a little bit, or did you want to do the song first? Why don't you tell everybody what's going on?
So what's up, church? All honor and glory to God. So this song that I wrote, it's called Going Through It. And I know a lot of us has gone through it. And we forget, though, when we're going through it, that everybody goes through it with us. You know what I mean? And that's why my kids are a big part of that. So I want them to come up, because they went through it with me. You know what I mean? Come on up, kids. My mom went through it with me. You know what I mean? My pastor, my brothers, you know what I mean? Everybody went through it with me. And we forget that sometimes. We go through these motions and we get caught up in our addiction or whatever it is that we get caught up in. And we forget that our children are watching, that they're going through it with us. You know what I mean? They're suffering along with everybody else. You know what I mean? So it's not just about the damage we do to ourselves, but it's the damage that we do to others. So that's why it was funny. We went up north and I was practicing this song so I can record it. And they were in the car with me. And so like they kept trying to help me and kept trying to help me. And I was like, why don't you guys just do the hook? Cause I'm trying to memorize it. You guys keep messing me up. So why don't you guys do the hook and I'll do my verses. And each time we would do it, it just kept ringing in my head. And God kept reminding me, they went through it with you. They're going through it right now with you. So that's why they're up here with me. All honor and glory to God. Thank God for keeping us safe, taking us through it, and bringing us out. So we're going to worship him real quick with this song that he gave me for the people that are going through it right now.
In the mighty name of Jesus, I'm going through it. Going through it, Lord.
I'm going through it, Lord, and I don't know if I can go anymore, but I raise my hands to the sky, surrender to you, Lord, bring these troubles to life. I'm going through it, Lord, and I don't know if I can go anymore, but I raise my hands to the sky, surrender to you, Lord, bring these troubles to life.
Hungover. With weed in my pocket, this pain in my heart next to the anger to block it. Regret, guilt, and shame keep calling my name, but who do I blame? Drink weed, meth, or cocaine with suicide and pain. I have all four in my brain. Insomnia taking over, I think I'm going insane. How did I end up here again? Shackled and captive, this in the road that I'm walking leads to cemetery. Oh, the pit, mixed emotions, followed up by commotion. It's building up inside, watch out, here comes the explosion. It sinks my battleship to the bottom of the ocean. It's destroying me like poison and corrosion. Confusion and depression, molested as adolescent. Abandonment and rejection, I have a lethal infection. action. If I die today, no peace, I will rest in. I'm ready to learn my lesson, this is my confession. I'm going through it, Lord, and I don't know if I can go anymore, but I raise my hands to the sky, surrender to you, Lord, bring these dry bones to life. I'm going through it, Lord, and I don't know if I can go anymore, but I raise my hands to the sky, surrender to you, Lord, bring these dry bones to life. Bloodshot eyes from all the tears that I cry. I don't understand, can you please explain why? This pain's so deep and buried deep down inside. Why am I alive? I'd rather lay down and die. I'm losing my faith and losing all hope. I'm losing all my feelings because my heart is broke. I'm miserable, horrible, terrible, unbearable. Worst pain in my life, I must say incomparable. I'm running to you, Lord, with everything that I got. I'm going through it, Lord, can you please make it stop? Can't take one more step, I feel I'm just gonna drop. Pay for me on the cross, that's where my soul was bought. So I surrender, Lord, drop to my knees, I give up. Please forgive me, Lord, I'm empty, please fill me up. You have saved me, Lord, and now your name I lift up. Thanks for your grace and mercy, now I'll never shut up. I'm going through it, Lord, and I don't know if I can go anymore, but I raise my hands to the sky, surrender to you, Lord, bring these troubles to life. I'm going through it, Lord, and I don't know if I can go anymore, but I raise my hands to the sky, surrender to you, Lord, bring these troubles to life.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
First of all, give me a high five. High five. High five. High five. High five. Okay, guys, get around your dad. Hang out right there. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Amen. How about that? God is good. Amen. I'm going to read something. Praise God. And then I'm going to have you take it from there and just share, I know you want to, God's using, man, I love you, man. I love your heart. And you're an inspiration. And God loves you, man.
And thank God, He does.
And better days are ahead. I've always said this, that effort only fully, I've heard this before a long time ago, and I've always said it to church, effort fully releases its reward when somebody refuses to give up. Someone needs to hear that. Effort fully releases its reward when somebody refuses to give up. But I want to have, there's one more saying here that I've read in the past. History has demonstrated that the most notable winners usually encountered heartbreaking obstacles before they triumphed. They won because they refused to become discouraged by their defeats. Galatians 6:9, and I'm going to give it to you from here. Galatians 6:9. Don't grow weary in doing good, for in due season you're going to reap a harvest. In Jesus' name, go ahead.
Amen, amen. So I asked Pastor for this opportunity because, like he mentioned, I had a victory, and I had a time in my life where, I mean, it was a complete year and 8 months that from when I relapsed. I had 5.5 years sober, and I relapsed, and it was a year and 8 months that I just drug myself back through my past, through the old me, drug them through it. They went through it with me, My oldest, she had seen that part of me, but these young ones, they never knew that part of Tony, They didn't know that alcoholic, drug addict dad, Tony. So they, and I know there's a reason behind it, because now they're going to appreciate the man of God, Tony, Because they don't know, you don't know what it is to be whole until you're broken, So I know that God has a great reason behind it. But so I fell, and I went through it, the motions, and asking God and just crying out to him, and I just couldn't get out of it. I was talking to a real good brother yesterday, and I said, I felt like I couldn't get out. I was clenched by this pain, this anger. And so I did good for a little. So last in November, I was like, okay, Lord, I had a bad night. And that's when I wrote this song. And the beginning of this song says, hungover with weed in my pocket. When I was writing this song, I was hungover with weed in my pocket. And I say, who do I blame? Drink weed, meth, or cocaine? I had all four in my brain at that time when I'm writing. And I'm like, Lord, because I asked God, I said, help me, Lord, change me. I know you have the power. You gave me 5.5 years sober, so I know you can do it. You've shown me before. Why can't I stop? Like, yeah, and he was like, write about this. Like, and I'm like, how can you use this? Look at where I'm at. He's all, write about that. Someone is going to be going through that. And when I transform and I change you and I heal you, you're going to be able to tell people that I did that for you. You're going to be a walking testimony, a living testimony that I can change that, what you're in right now. Write about it. And I told Pastor, and he's like, I believe that, man. It's going to help people. I didn't want to write. I'm like, how's God going to use that? And this song's pretty raw. You know what I mean? It talks about what I was going through, how I was feeling, miserable, horrible, you know, And so I got victory for 30 days. I remember it was when they gave out the presents out here, the outreach. And I told you, Pastor, 30 days, I haven't drank. And you know what I mean? God put me up here to talk, and I gave my testimony. And then I didn't protect it, though. After that, I said, oh, you know what? It was a Christmas party for my work. And I said, I'm going to go out. I'm having one last hurrah. And when I went to that last hurrah, I couldn't get back up. I mean, I fell pretty hard, and I couldn't shake it. And I was praying, and I was asking God, and I couldn't get loose of it. And so it brought shame. The devil kept telling me, Pastor put it on TV, and people were like, oh, brother, I saw your testimony. How powerful. And I was like, how powerful? Like, you don't know how terrible I feel that I failed God again. I did it again, man. After he gave me this victory, I did it again. My kids, you know me, saw me pray and cry and ask God, and they saw the short victory, 30 days, and then there goes Dad again. There I go again, back into the mud, back into the vomit again. And it wasn't fun, you know, and it came back to I kept coming, I kept pressing in, I kept asking God, like reaching out to my brothers, man. You can't do it alone. I guarantee you that you will not do it if you're not accountable, if you can't pick up a phone and say, brother, I'm struggling, even to say I'm drinking right now, I'm messed up, you need to pray with me, I'm coming over, brother, and we're going to hang out, and you're going to walk me through this, we're going to do it. Iron sharpens iron, man.
That's right.
We need each other.
That's right.
You need to reach out to someone. Don't think that you're going to get this alone. Don't think that you're just going to be able to say, okay, Lord, I'll come to you once I get this dirt off me, I'll come. No, he wants you dirty, but he wants you to walk
come
along.
As you are. Come,
yeah,
as, you
come
are.
As you are. You
and,
can't, you can't
and I was
going to
say, Tony, I just wanted to insert this, that, you know, sometimes when we get into situations, that one of the things that keeps people in a place of defeat is our pride gets in the way. And we just have to, because someone needs to hear that, get rid of the pride. And God is the one that's going to do it, but God uses people also to help us. So you got to be able to get rid of the pride and be willing to receive the help that God's bringing to you. I'm sorry, I just wanted to say that's big. And you said one more thing I need, that someone, you know, you didn't protect your miracle, because someone needs to hear this even after tonight. God's going to do the miracle as you call upon his name. Praise God. Those who call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Turn to me in the day of trouble and I'll deliver and you honor me. Amen. That's all. But then afterwards, then he gives us the wisdom to do the possible. And the possible is being in church, reading the word, being around the right people, staying away from the wrong people.
Not going to the Christmas party.
And I was just
going
to say, don't go to the Christmas party. See, God, you see, we don't need to pray like, oh, God, help me from the Christmas. No, that's something, you know, God's already given you the wisdom that if I go there, that is going to put me in a place of temptation. Amen. See, so we already know we can't go there. So we always say it here, if you're in a place of victory, you can't be in a place of defeat. So moving forward tonight, because people need to hear this, as you move forward, continue to place yourself in places of victory, because it eliminates places of defeat and temptation completely when you're in a place of victory. Go ahead, because this is great. This is awesome.
So, yeah, so.
And don't go to the Christmas party.
Don't go to the Christmas party.
Don't go to the Christmas party.
Especially
amen.
If you know they're handing out
unless
free
it's a,
drink
unless
tickets.
It's a fire and water. Amen.
Amen, amen. And so, you know, I didn't protect that victory, and I took it lightly, you know. And it's crazy because I went to a Christian concert, and one of the brothers said that he was freshly saved, and he said, you know what, I'm gonna go back to the weed house and I'm gonna go preach to everybody. He said, I'm gonna be real with you, I left there high. You know what I mean? We can't just walk back into them places. We're not ready. You know what I mean? We're not ready. We're not, you know what I mean, strong enough. We're setting ourselves up for failure. You know what I mean?
Good word.
So I fell, and here I go going through it again, and it just seemed like it was getting worse. And I'll never forget, man, I went to another party that I knew I shouldn't have gone to, you know? Praise the Lord. Me just being hard-headed, doing my thing. And so I go, and I end up going with the kids, and I get drunk, and I got to go home. And I end up going back. I leave the kids at home with my mom, and I go back. I don't get home till 4:30 in the morning. I mean, in a bad shape. And I remember I didn't want to come to church, and you know, my mom obviously disappointed in my actions, you know, and who can blame her, you know? She's human. She feels pain to see her son dragging himself through the mud. And so I remember I came to church and I sat way back there in the corner. I didn't want to be here. And I was just like, Lord, like, what am I doing, Lord? This can't be your plan for me, man. And I remember pastor, first thing he said Sunday morning, he's like, yeah, somebody already came up and they left their crack pipe and a beer and stuff. And I was just like, man, I got weed in the car. I got a brand new pack of cigarettes. I got coke in my wallet. I said, I need to surrender this. I said, Lord, I'm done, Lord, today, Lord. And I went right away, and I went to my car and got the weed and stuff, and I sat there and I listened. We went through the worship. We went through everything, and he started preaching, and it wasn't even, he was about to start the altar call, but it wasn't even ready. I made my way up here.
He came right up.
And I came and I gave my Pastor Tony a hug. He's one of the brothers that's been there. My brother David Wade, I love you, man. My brother Luis, you guys have been there for me, man. And I remember standing there and I just threw it up there. Yeah. And it took a lot because I had, you know what I mean, the devil, the regret, guilt, and shame kept calling my name and saying, how's God going to use you? You let him down so much. You were up there testifying. You were on TV. People are going to see that. What are they going to think about God? Who are you to come up and put your stuff up there? And I said, I don't care what anybody sees, thinks, says. I don't care, Lord. I'm bringing it to you. You're going to take this from me. I don't care who's here. I don't care who sees. As long as you see this in my heart, Lord, that you know, Lord, that I know, that power, Lord, that same power that rose Jesus out of that grave is going to bring me back to life. That was February 16th. Thursday was my 60 days, completely sober.
This past Thursday.
This last Thursday.
How many days?
60 days. But them 60 days, I learned something real quick in this. Them 60 days would have never got there without my first victory. So that was Sunday.
This is good.
Wednesday.
This is good.
I get to work, and we're about to clock out. And my boss is like, hey, everybody going to this conference room. I got something for you guys. And we're like, oh, who messed up? Who didn't do something right? Like, who's he going to yell at? What do we do? What are they changing in the process? Like, where are we at? We get in there, and he pulls two bottles of champagne out of a bag, and he pops the bottles and pours everybody a drink and brings everybody a drink. And right there, the devil starts saying, you can have this one cup. You can have this one cup. And I was like, no, because I know if I have this one cup, I'm going to go to the liquor store after this, and I'm going to go get some cocaine. Then who knows where I'm going to be after that with this one cup.
God, that's good.
I can't have this one cup. Lord, help me. And then I saw another brother there, and he was crying. And I was like, what's wrong with him? They're like, he's been sober. So I was like, man, if he's protecting his victory. And then, the devil told me, he's like, man, it's only been 3 days. It's been 3 days. Who matters if you have a drink right now? It's not like you're giving up 30 days or 60 days or 2 months. Or it's something small. You can have a drink. It's only been 3 days. You're not breaking a big record. It's not like 5 years or anything.
This is good.
But the Holy Spirit, I know, clear as day.
Don't miss this. Hear this, people.
Told me, the Holy Spirit said, Tony, you're never going to hit those 30 days if you don't protect these three.
Whoa.
If you can't protect these 3 days, if you can't protect these 3 days, you're never going to be able to protect 30. God says, I need to see you be faithful with the little. If we can't be faithful, I can't be faithful with those 3 days. To me, to the devil was trying to play him off to be so small. But on 3 days, Jesus rose from the grave.
Amen.
It took only 3 days. So I said, you know what, Lord, you're right. You know what, Spirit, you're right. I need to protect these 3 days if I ever want 30. How am I going to ever hit 30 if I can't take care of three?
Or and get to 60 then.
Yeah, how am I going to get to 60? And so I remember getting in my car and just crying and thanking God and saying, Lord, you showed me something important today. I need to take care of these 3 days like I'm taking care of 5 years, because I'm never going to see five if I can't take care of three.
That's a word.
Gosh, so I remember praying and crying out to God and just giving him glory and telling him thank you. And I remember so fired up that God, that's been 60 days. I'm going to hit 10 years. I'm a die sober. But without those 3 days, man, even right now, if it's been 30 minutes and you say, Lord, you changed me, you got to protect those 30 minutes. Don't say, well, it was only 30 minutes ago. You got to protect that right now.
Come on, preacher.
If you want to see tomorrow sober, you got to protect them 30 minutes. You're never going to get to tomorrow sober.
Preach
if
it.
You can't make it past this 30 minutes. And I know it ain't easy, man. I know. Most of my life has been an addict and an alcoholic. I know it, man. I'm telling you, black kettle calls the kettle black. I know, man. I know it. I know it's not easy. But with him, it's possible. I couldn't do it on my own. I can't do it on my own. Every day I have to hit my knees. My mom knows when I'm up because that worship music is going. I'm on my knees and I'm like, okay, Lord, give me my daily bread for today.
That's it.
Give me my encouragement for today. Give me my strength for today. Give me my sobriety for today. One day at a time. But if I don't hit my knees first, my whole day is bad.
Yes.
So it's protect awesome. Your 3 days. Protect your 30 minutes.
Yes.
Protect it. Don't give up. That's one thing I asked Pastor. Hey, man, I just want to tell somebody, one soul, don't give up, man. Don't. It's so beautiful on the other end.
Yeah, don't give up.
It's so beautiful. It's so easy. 60 days ago, I wanted to die. I'd rather be dead. That song says it. Why am I alive? I'd rather be dead right now. But God, man, changed all of that.
Yes.
I couldn't even see these glorious blessings I have because I was so caught up in my mess. And look at these beautiful children God's giving me, man.
Yes.
We spend so much time, man. We go on hikes. We go fishing. We took a bike ride yesterday. Like, man, I was missing out.
Yes.
You guys are amazing.
And the best is, and greater days are ahead. And, you know, Tony, you said something very powerful. You know, those 3 days, the enemy is like, oh, it's just 3 days. But we know, and through the word of God, big things come from small places. And I just talked about a fire in the natural, you know, as far as a wildfire. You know, when a wildfire starts, it starts with a spark. And then you hear on the news sometimes like acres and acres of that have been burned, right? But if you rewind the tape when the fire first started, it was just a small spark, a small something. And it becomes this big fire. So, the devil is a liar. That what's 3 days or what's 30 minutes? It's big because 30 minutes leads to 3 days. 3 days leads to 30 days. 30 days to 60. 60 to 1 year. 1 year to 10 years for the glory.
Until Jesus comes back.
And
you call me.
Come on.
You call me the next day and you're like, man, I was encouraged, Tony, because it took courage for you to come up here and do that after, you know what I mean, testifying. And it took courage to do that. And he's like, And so that day was February 16th. That's the same exact date that I stopped when I stopped for 5.5 years. So I know there's some significance behind it. I didn't even know. I was still buzzed when I came to church. I didn't even know it was that day. But it was the same exact day that I stopped last time. And remember, you called me the next day and you're like, hey, you know, I'm encouraged. And I said, look, Pastor, I didn't even know. It was the same day, February 16th, the same exact date that you said, yeah, but this time it's until the day Jesus comes. I was like, I received that.
I received that
in Jesus' name. And that day that I got my victory with the 3 days, when I was praising the Lord and I was just giving him glory and just thanking him that he gave me that one victory. I said, that one victory. And I remember I started declaring stuff. Sometimes we got to declare stuff. I remember telling them addictions. I said, you know addiction? Them same chains that had me bound, I come against you in the mighty name of Jesus. And I bind you with them same chains. Them Woo! Same chains that had me wrapped up and I couldn't get out of. I bind you, Woo! Addiction. I bind you, alcohol. I bind you, cocaine.
In the name of Jesus,
marijuana.
Even right now for somebody.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Those same chains, Pastor says it all the time, with the devil try to use to destroy me, God's going to use it for his glory. Those Woo! Same exact chains bind you in the name of Jesus, and I throw you in the pit of hell.
Amen.
And I don't have, since then, I don't even have the desire for anything.
Amen.
All I have that desire, I have a new addiction. It's called Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
It's a good one, too. God's so good, man. I got to give him glory and thanks for loving me when I didn't love myself. And I'm going to say it one more time. Get around brothers that want to see you succeed. Find some mature brothers, sisters. Find some mature sisters in Christ and latch on to them like there's nothing else in this world. I mean, you're going to have to swallow your pride. You're going to have to be
yes.
transparent with
yes.
them and tell them, look, I'm struggling here. I'm struggling there. But, man,
So you know what? I'm going to tell you something. I know because, like, you know, from personal experience also, how good God is. And remember, the enemy's like, you know, oh, how can you go? What are people going to say? What people are saying is right now, as you're hearing this, what they're saying, you see, the enemy's just a liar. What they're saying is they're seeing the goodness, the mercy, the patience, the faithfulness of God. That's what's happening right now because this is the God we serve. When we want to give up, he never gives up on us. This is the God we serve. Don't give up. Keep on keeping on. Get back up. Amen. Get back up and don't give up. And I'm going to tell you something. And I'm, you know, you've heard me. People have heard, you know, multiple times during services. I know this is real. And you know what? I wouldn't be where I'm at. You know, if it wasn't for me at a certain point in my life where I needed to humble myself and receive help. I'm telling you straight up. And that wasn't an easy thing to do. But I didn't want to go out that way. When I knew God was saying, I got a plan for your life, and I'm going to use you to reach others. And what the enemy meant for evil, like you said, for destruction, God's going to use for the good. For so many people right now are listening. This is powerful. Your liabilities, the things that were trying to destroy you right now, multiple times over and over, God's going to turn around for assets in his hands to help others. In Jesus' name. I want to encourage you right now. I feel this as we finish here tonight. Man, I'm not saying this just to say it. God is using you not to encourage, he's using you to encourage many right now that are watching, but it helps me. You're encouraging me. Because we all have, you know, we're talking about some major, but we're always like, God's always trying to work on us on something. And I'm telling you, that's a powerful thing. Those 3 days, every time, when you said those 3 days and how the enemy came in those 3 days, but it's like, yeah, 3 days, it doesn't seem like a lot, but actually it is. I'm telling you, that's ministering to people. Right now at home, somebody, and there's probably more than one, but I know there's one for sure, but I think there's many more, but for sure one. But that didn't even make sense. For sure one, but I know there's many more. Now that, someone's thinking, how did this guy ever become pastor of the church? Amen.
He uses the crazy, but he's crazy.
Amen. The foolish things, amen.
Amen.
But I'm telling you right now, and we know, and I know Tony knows this, and everyone that's connected to this church, is an anointing for breakthrough in this church from addictions. And I'm telling you, big time. One of the things that God always leads us in these services is one of the steps to your miracle is if you have anything that you are struggling with, whatever it might be right now at home, I want to encourage you. Tony came on a Sunday morning, brought it all up here. The weed, the cocaine, what was it, cigarettes, brought it all up here. And now it's 60 days later. If you're at home right now, because we're in closing prayer right now, I want you to flush that thing down the toilet, whatever it is.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. And in the name of Jesus, I decree and declare your miracle starts at that point.
Amen, amen.
Get rid of it right now. Get rid of it right now.
Don't hesitate. Don't hesitate.
Right now.
Don't think about what's going to happen.
Get rid of it.
Yeah.
Get rid of it.
Now.
You're not going out that way in Jesus' name. God's got a plan for your life.
Yes.
God has a plan for your life, and he's going to use you. Yes.
And God's brought Tony and his family right now to encourage you, to show you footsteps to follow. He's going to use you, and it's not over. It's only getting started, but get rid of it starting tonight. But the miracle starts by surrendering to him, giving your heart to Jesus. For my prodigal sons and daughters, God's saying, come back home. To somebody that's watching right now that's never given their hearts to Jesus, you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you, but you got to have him in your heart. So, Tony, I want you to lead them in a prayer of salvation right now. I want you to pray this prayer with Tony right now. The Bible says, those who call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. My friends, it's not the way you start, it's the way you finish. And God is not intimidated with your sins, but he died for every one of your sins. A righteous man falls seven times, but he gets back up. Tonight's your night. Your miracle starts with a relationship with Jesus. Tony, would you lead him in a prayer of salvation?
Amen, amen. So, guys, pray this prayer. Just don't repeat it. Say it with your heart. I know the words are going to come out of your mouth, but let them build out of your heart. God knows that you're tired. He knows that you don't want that anymore. He knows, but he also needs you to do the possible. When you do,
you can
surrender.
Do it.
When you do it, you got to also, hey, I can't go back there. I can't go hang out over there. So let's pray.
Come on.
Dear Heavenly Father, I need you, Lord.
I need you.
I can't do this anymore.
I can't do this
And anymore. I know I can't do it without you, Father. So I come and I surrender, Lord. I ask you, forgive me, Lord, of my sins. Make me a new person, Lord. Wash me with that precious blood, Lord. I believe, Lord, that you came and that you died on that cross, Lord. And I thank you, Lord, for taking my sins, Lord. And I thank you, Lord, for making me brand new, Lord. And I ask you, Lord, that you remove everything that isn't of you. And that you put every ounce of you back into me, Lord. You fill me right now, Lord, with your Holy Spirit, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for this new opportunity, Lord. Give me that new strength, Lord, that I can do everything, Lord, with you, Father. So I thank you, Lord. And I praise you, Lord. And I surrender, Lord, to you. I thank you for my new life. Jesus. And I thank you for this new strength, Lord. Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we pray.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
In the name of
God
Jesus.
God bless you guys. God bless. Hey,
and if someone just prayed that for the first time, let us know. Amen. And welcome to the family of God. Praise the Lord. Get back up and move forward and be the champion that God's called you to be. Amen. God has a plan for your life. And he hasn't given up on you. And it's not too late. Amen. Praise the Lord. Well, you know what? We're going to finish with a praise song or something. What do we got? You guys, where's mom? Mom, come up, please. Mom, come up here. Praise the Lord. Mom's in the house. We got her. Social distancing, right? Amen. Well, praise
She's
the Lord.
All the way in the back.
All the way in the back for everybody that's watching. It's like, well, where's everybody? Everybody's in, you know, in safe places. But this is one of those moments where I know. Well, we don't have. How many do we have here? There's not 10. Amen. Come in. Give your praise God. Amen. Oh, come on. Somebody celebrate in this, right where you're at. Amen. This is what it's all about. Hallelujah. Amen. This is prophetic right here for what God's going to do in your life and in your families. Amen. Restoration, breakthrough, healing, deliverance. This picture is prophetic of what God's going to do in your life in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Come on. Come on. Hallelujah.
My God, that is who you are.
Yeah. I can see it, you're working.
What?
Even though I can feel it,
what?
You're working.
What?
You never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. Even though I can see it, you're working.
The Lord. God is still on his throne. And Tony, you said something, and I heard it a while ago back, and I shared it on Facebook a couple days ago. Speaking it, taking authority. Do you know, in the beginning, in Genesis chapter 1, God said it, and it was so.
Yeah.
He said it, and it was. So before it was written for us to read, it was spoken, but it was written for us to read it, but not just to read it, not just to meditate on it, but it was written for us to speak it. Because death and life are in the power of the tongue, Proverbs 18:21. So I want to encourage you, moving forward, it was written for us to pick it up and speak it, because our words create our future. My God, our words create our future. Pick up the word of God, the promises of God, believe it, receive it, and then speak it forth. Amen. There's power in it, there's victory in it, there's breakthrough in it, there's peace in it. My God, amen. Hallelujah. We'll be back tomorrow morning, 10:30 a.m. Get the word out, Facebook, on the web, and don't forget Monday night prayer. We'll be live streaming Monday night, 7 p.m. God willing, we'll see you tomorrow morning. Come on, what do we got?
Hey, 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 hey.